Charger Lab got a Motorola 50 watts charger. It adopts a European plug, a USB-A port, and a USB-C port. Its shell is frosted and anti-fingerprint. The Motorola logo is engraved on the front. There is a bright 50 on the back, indicating the maximum output power. The specs info is printed on the side. Model is MC507. It can support input of 100 to 240 volts 50 or 60 Hz 2 amps. It has passed level 6 energy efficiency certification. Here is the European plug. The plastic sheets of the USB-A and USB-C ports are black. Its size is about 57.97 by 43.42 by 28.82 mm. That's how big it is in the hand. The weight is about 112.6 grams. ChargerLab Power ZKM003C shows the USB-C port can support PD3.0, PPS, QC4, and DCP charging protocols. And it has four fixed PDOs of 5 volts 3 amps, 9 volts 3 amps, 15 volts 3 amps, 20 volts 2.5 amps, and a set of PPS. Our tester shows the USB-A port can support QC 3.0, DCP, and Apple 2.4 amp charging protocols. Next, let's take it apart. First, pry along the gap to open the input cover. The PCBA module is connected to the plug through wires. Cut the wires. The PCBA module is wrapped with heat sinks, and the gaps between components are filled with potting compounds for reinforcement. There is a mylar sheet between the heat sink and the PCB on the back for insulation. Remove the heat sinks. There is a thermal pad on the transformer. There are also thermal pads on the area corresponding to the bridge rectifier and the master control chip to help with heat conduction. Clean up the potting compounds. The components on the front are compactly arranged. The output end has a separate small PCB. There are two bridge rectifiers and a master control chip on the back. These two bridge rectifiers are from YJ and adopt the YBS package. 3 amps 1000 volts. These two electrolytic capacitors are from Samsung. 15 microfarad 400 volts. The other two electrolytic capacitors are from Chenex. 27 microfarad 400 volts. The ferrite bead is used to suppress high frequency interference. The master control chip is from PI. It is the InnoSwitch 3 Pro series, which is a digitally controlled constant voltage. Constant current offline flyback quasi-resonant switcher IC with integrated synchronous rectification and FluxLink feedback functions. The capacitor that powers the master control chip is from Samsung. 10 microfarad 100 volts. The blue Y capacitor marked with CD221K is from ST. The synchronous rectifier is from Virgiga and adopts the PDFN5060X package. The withstand voltage is 100 volts, and the resistance is 3.8 milliohm. Here is the solid capacitor for output filtering. 820 microfarad 25 volts. Here is another solid capacitor. 560 microfarad 25 volts. The front of the small PCB at the output end has components such as protocol chip, synchronous buck converter, buck inductor, solid capacitor for output filtering, and V-bus MOSFET. There are small devices such as capacitors and resistors on the back. The synchronous buck converter is from UTEC and adopts the SOP8 EP package. It supports an input voltage range of 4.5 volts to 30 volts, supports pass-through mode, has a built-in MOSFET on the chip, and supports a maximum output current of 4 amps. The solid capacitor is used for secondary buck output filtering of the USB port. 180 microfarad 16 volts. The protocol chip is from Injoinic. It integrates multiple protocols with high integration and rich functions. The USB-C output V-bus MOSFET is marked with 050N03B. The USB-A output V-bus MOSFET is marked with 1233AG. Here is the component list of the Motorola 50 watts charger for your convenience. It has a simple design. It is equipped with USB-A and USB-C output ports and is compatible with the two universal fast charging protocols, QC 3.0 and PD 3.0. The USB-C port also supports BPS. After taking it apart, we found it adopts a PI master control chip and Virginia synchronous rectifier. It adopts the Ingenic protocol chip used to control the output of the two ports. The PCBA module has been adequately heat dissipated and insulated and is well made. Okay. That's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you next time. Bye.